Good evening, everyone. My name is Patricia Halpin, and I want it to be known that I have no aspirations to be in this seat. This is for someone else. I am the chair of the Affordable Housing Trust, and I welcome you all tonight. I lament the distance between us, but hopefully our evening tonight will be productive and supportive of all. First of all, since it's a hybrid meeting, we need to do a roll call vote. So, Mark Frieden.
Present.
Bob Barrell.
Present.
Christopher Berglund.
Present.
Marcia Cairns.
Present.
Anna Mary Kramer.
Yes, I'm here. Present.
And Patricia Halpin. Great. By way of introduction, the members of the trust include Bob Barrell, who is the former chair of the Housing Authority of Hudson and the Board of Health in town and is still on the Board of Health in town. We have Marcia Cairns, who is the chair of the West Boylston Housing Authority. We have and also co-chair of the Disabilities Commission. And then Christopher Berglund is the chair of the finance committee in town and also a member of the West Boylston Housing Authority and a former trust officer of the Marlboro Savings Bank. And anyone else?
Mark
Frieden, member of the select board, member of the planning board, and faithful member of this committee. We have been meeting long and hard over the years seeking to find land, an appropriate place to build the senior housing that our housing needs analysis called for. It's a laborious task and very difficult in a town that is primarily owned by the state and has the buildable land is very scarce. I will entertain a motion to postpone the approval of the minutes of the November and December meeting.
So moved.
Mark Frieden moves.
I'll second.
Marsh Karen seconds. All in favor?
Aye.
Roll call vote. Okay. Mark?
Aye.
Bob?
Yes.
Marcia?
Aye.
Christopher?
Aye.
Anna Mary?
Aye.
And Pat Halpin? Aye. Thank you. We have before us tonight, as you all know, three proposals, each seeking the recommendation of the Affordable Housing Trust. The recommendation to the select board to create a LIP, a local initiative program. The importance of a LIP to a developer is that it secures approval and facilitates the process for the developer going forward, working with the state and working with the agencies of the West Boylston town. The trust has done due diligence, listening to the proposals of each and aligning each of to the strategic goals stated in three documents that are on our website, this town's website, the townwide planning master plan of 2005, the housing needs analysis of 2017, and the housing production plan of 2019. And we, to aid our discussion and thinking, we created a grid that had these goals outlined, and each of us were to listen carefully to the presentations and then rate how we felt that each proposal aligned with the goals articulated here. That's our only scope of authority to recommend to the select board. Any other issues, for instance, traffic, sewers, and so forth, are to be directed directly to the town administrator, Warren Diamond, and the select board. Okay. So the first proposal of this evening is the proposal of Branded Management Realty Group 3 LLC for a 64 unit project at 235 West Boylston Street. I'll entertain a motion.
I move for the purpose of a discussion that the Affordable Housing Trust
recommend to the select board that enter into a LIP with Branded Realty Group, LLC, for the development at 235-245 West Boylston Street.
Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Wait a minute. Well, we're going to have to do once, twice, three, shoot. Okay. So it's Mark. Mark will second it. Okay. All right. Members of the trust, given your alliance sheets.
Can I do my disclosure?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm going to be offering the opinion as myself on the Affordable Housing Trust Board, not as a select board or planning board or anybody else member.
Okay. Very good. Thank you, Mark. So how is your, anyone want to go forward? Do we want to go concept by concept? We've all done this at home.
I think we should each speak to the proposal and then.
Right.
Maybe take a vote on that particular one if we want
to. Yeah, we're just doing proposal one. Yeah. Right now.
And which is Branded Realty.
Which is Branded Realty. Those of you who have attended previous meetings, Branded, this is opposite Dunkin' Donuts on West Boylston Street. And it's a project that would allow do commercial as well as housing. And so let me read to you the strategic goals and then you can see how our thoughts went. The question is, does it align with West Boylston's master plan? And do we want to do that individually? I say it aligns with West Boylston's master plan.
I would agree. Yep. No, I would agree. Yep. With that said.
Yes.
Mark?
I agree.
Okay. Yes. Does it align with the housing production plan goals that yes. are outlined in these?
Yes.
Bob says yes. Mark?
With respect to rental, yes.
Yes.
Well, do you think we should tell them what the goal was, risk yeah. for that, the master plan?
Well, you know, no.
I think.
It's a whole sheet, Bob, and it's and every meeting we've told people that these documents are available.
Okay.
Right.
I mean, come on, okay. You know. And so it's fairly the executive, if anyone wants a copy, we have an executive summary here, but one a particular one, it's a variety of housing at low income to moderate income, which suits the small town environment and has access to public facilities. And it becomes very obvious. And if anyone wants a copy, I would be happy to give it to you to take home for your scrapbooks, your records. All right. Does it align with the best West Boylston housing needs analysis? I say yes, because it's rental units, because it has universal access. Aims to provide housing for seniors as well as others. That's my vote. Chris, do you have an opinion on it?
You know, in Pat, Madam Chair, I guess the one thing I want to, because I did go over all these documents a lot, and the one thing, and I don't want to speak just to this project, but I think all of them, the one thing that they were missing was they weren't. None of them were providing affordable housing, you know, as proposed by what was, I don't know, what was the production.
That's coming down.
That's
here.
Coming down. All right. Yeah.
If I go through all these strategic, no, but we'll get to that.
Otherwise, it did check the box for me, but I guess the very low income was.
Okay. Well, this is a good question. Provides a variety of housing options, affordability, and population served. And so, Chris, you've made that very good point. And later on in the grid, we talk about the AMI and so forth. But it's a question. Provides preferential consideration for West Boylston residents and municipal employees. I have That's unknown to me.
That's right.
To me too.
They didn't go into any of that.
No, and we all have to understand that we're limited by the statutes about how much can be reserved for the community. Am I right, Jennifer? And it has to go out to the public and so forth. So that goal is moot, I think.
Or the same for all of them, whichever way you want to say it. They all seem to say the same thing,
yeah.
Which is that they're going to do what you just said.
Okay. Right, they'll abide by the state statutes.
Right.
All right. Location and siting criteria. This is more specific, and this comes out of our document, okay? Proximity to public transportation is a key goal. All right, Chris?
Yes, no, absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes for me? Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay, absolutely. Proximity to retail grocery stores.
Yeah. Yes.
Who else? Oh, Anne, I keep forgetting you. I'm so sorry.
Keep forgetting me. I'm here.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
We'll record you as yeses, correct?
Yes.
Existing traffic and pedestrian ways adequately serve the project. I'm unclear of that.
I'm unclear of that as well, but I think it does. Because of their location to, well, that's the other one. I'm unclear.
My only opinion there is that it does its best in as much as we don't, the town doesn't have sidewalks everywhere.
Right.
So that's something that could be negotiated.
And it seems like it has two access. And
oh, it does very well, besides the fact that there's not a sidewalk.
Yeah.
And that would be fall with the other agencies to negotiate that, the sidewalks and the clearing, like other state town departments. Okay. Existing public utilities, sewer and water serve the site. Chris?
Yeah.
I think yes.
Anna Mary?
Yes.
Mark?
Best of all, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, strongly yes. All right. Generally conforms to existing neighborhood development.
Yes. I'm going to say yes.
Yeah, I think
yes.
It does.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. I believe it does.
Affordability criteria. Here we are, Chris. there's a minimum of 25% affordable rental units. Yes. Right? We're hoping to have more, but this proposal said it had the minimum of 25% of affordable. 75% would be market rate. But with a rental under 40B, every unit counts.
Yep.
Which is towards our SHI, which are subsidized housing inventory. That is the 10% that provides a safe harbor for communities from unfriendly projects. Okay. So it would be 20 meets that. Provide affordable units for less than 50% AMI. You realize the AMI is 80, is the regulation is that 80% of the adjusted medium income, and we're in the Worcester, Shrewsbury, everything area. So 80% is quite high for rentals. We asked each developer, would they consider getting it lower to help people on fixed income? And so forth. And well, we're not sure. We got to put pencil to paper, but we'll see. So it's negotiable. Does that make sense? Okay. So what do you feel about that, gentlemen and ladies?
I'd say they're not providing the 50% AMI.
No.
Right.
I
agree.
None of them have said
said they would either.
Right.
One did indicate that he would with significant incentives.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But that would be, and I think he cited an example down in Mendon that he had done. The developer, I don't recall which project, but he said it was going to take hundreds of thousands of dollars per unit, I mean, to make it.
Oh, decent. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Which we're not. And this was not included. And this project was not included in that.
I agree. Provide affordable units with universal access. Yes.
Well, he doesn't though, because it's a three-story, isn't it?
There's no elevator on this, right?
Right.
But they are going to provide
first floor units.
First floor units. All right. So, is there anything more that you want to discuss on this, or is there anything from the audience that hasn't been said before that you feel that you would like to add? Not hearing. Anyone on Zoom? All right. Members of the trust, are you prepared to vote tonight?
Yeah.
Sure. All right.
This one.
Anna Mary, on this proposal, I would
recommend that we move forward to the selection or whatever the wording should be.
So your vote is a yes, Anna Mary.
My vote is a yes.
Yes, ready to vote.
Oh.
There's
a motion.
Oh, okay.
That was just a question.
Oh, all right.
Not a Robert's Rules question.
Okay.
So your vote is a yes, Anna Mary?
Yes.
Mark?
I vote yes.
Bob?
I do. Yes.
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
And I vote yes. So we have voted to move this, recommend to the select board to pursue a LIP program with this developer. And that will bring us 64 units towards our SHI. All right. The second proposal before us tonight is the proposal of Crescent Builders for a 36-unit development at 75 West Boylston Street.
I move for the purpose of a discussion that the Affordable Housing Trust recommend to the Select Board that it enter into a LIP with Crescent Builders for the development at 75 West Boylston Street.
Is there a second? Marsha Cairns seconds. All right, discussion, everyone. Shall we proceed the same way?
Yeah, sure.
Is it pretty clear? All right, so under general concepts, how does this proposal from Mr. Ali, Crescent Builders, align with the West Boylston goals and the master plan?
I think that it does.
I think it does.
Yes, it does. Yeah.
Given the location. So that's it. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. And it's a yes from me.
Great. Yes for you, everyone.
Yes,
yes for me. All right, good. How about align with West Boylston housing production plan? You know, the incremental good location kind of thing. That.
Yes.
Chris, yes. Marsha, yes. Mark.
Yes, lesser than the other one, but yes.
Yes.
Anna Mary?
Yes.
And myself, yes. Provides a variety of housing options, affordability, and population served. I think it could be better. I'm unclear about that. How about you people?
I'm kind of unclear about that as well.
Oh, yeah, I didn't have it aligning with that at all. I mean,
sorry,
I didn't have this project aligning with the housing needs. I mean, from a standpoint of serving those that need to be served, but I didn't have any of them at this point. So.
Yeah. Okay. So how about you, Mark or Bob? What do you feel about it's something that can be negotiated. You know what I'm saying?
And he provides the legal limit to then answer that question.
Yes, so the legal
limit. And that seems to be what his answer is.
Provides preferential consideration. I think we've mentioned before that
none of them
do. Okay, location siting criteria, proximity to public transportation.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Anna Mary?
Yes.
Okay. Proximity to retail grocery stores.
Yes.
Yes.
Definitely. Yes. Yes. Yeah. All right. Existing public utilities, sewer, water, serve the site.
Yes.
Generally conforms to existing neighborhood development.
Yeah.
As long as it's mindful of the neighbors behind, is some issue with abutters in the area behind. So that is something that we should point out to whoever, ZBA or whatever, forward. Is that fair to say, Jen? Mm-hmm. Okay. Located at an underutilized commercial site.
Yes.
Yes.
Create small scale neighborhood development.
No.
Okay. Affordability criteria. A minimum 25% affordable rental units.
Yes.
Provide affordable units for less than 50% AMI.
No.
Provide affordable units with universal access. Yes. On the first floor.
First floor, yeah, that's it. It's not universal, but it's...
Yeah.
All right. Any input that we haven't heard before from the audience?
I mean, if you're gonna take, you're going to take comments from the audience.
Yeah. David?
All I have is, if you move on with these two boards of selectmen, would this put us over on the SHI?
According to, yes.
No,
not a 2010-20.
So with the timing issue, it's in order for them to be counted on the SHI, they need to be not only approved through this body, not only approved through the select board, not only be pending before the ZBA, but a comprehensive permit needs to be issued by the ZBA, and the state needs to add them to the SHI. So it is theoretically possible, depending on timing.
Okay.
The quantity.
Does everyone
but the
understand?
Quantity of the two combined, if these two were to be granted comprehensive permits by the ZBA and added to the SHI, then yes, for the 2020 census, we will have met our 10%.
Chris?
To clarify to you, Madam Chair, and maybe our town administrator wants to get involved, but correct me, but don't building permits essentially have to be issued?
So there's
for them to be counted.
That's so the first step is that they are issued a comprehensive permit and they're counted on the SHI
Okay.
Then there's the building permit buys another year.
Thank you.
All right. Is the trust on the trust members prepared to vote?
Madam Chair, one question, and I don't know. I guess I was a little concerned, and I don't know that we can include this in our discussion. But at one of the meetings, I know there was some citizen concern about this developer's ability to, perform. And I know we. I guess we really can't include that though in this assessment, correct? Because it's not.
I don't think so.
No,
that would be before this body.
Thank you. All right.
Reasonable question. So this is very formal. Don't make me laugh. So, excuse me. Erase that. You know, the hard thing is I had to watch videos of this of the previous meetings because to make sure I had the information right. It's so painful to watch yourself. anyway, it's time for a vote. Whether we support Bob's motion to move this forward. Mark, do you have?
I will, speaking as my, with my Affordable Housing Trust hat on, I will vote yes for this project.
I also vote yes.
Christopher?
I would vote to recommend this to the Board of Selectmen for the project, yes.
Yes.
And Marcia and Anna Mary?
Yes.
And I'm an I too. So that makes two of the proposals. All right, the third proposal, the proposal of SJV Investment LLC for a 192 unit development at 18 Walden Street.
I move for the purpose of a discussion that the Affordable Housing Trust recommend to the Select Board that it enter into a LIP with SJV Investment LLC for a development at 18 Walden Street.
A second.
No. Oh, no, let's get someone else.
Okay, get someone else. For the purposes of discussion, right. I will second.
Yeah. That's very key. So, all right, we'll go through the general concepts. Align with the West Boylston goals and the master plan. The master plan. Wanted to, page 71 was, you know, in a neighborhood area, preserving the rural feeling of small town environment. Am I correct?
That's correct.
And to my way of thinking, that's questionable.
I agree. I mean, it's very questionable.
I don't think it really accommodates the purpose of the master plan. And I know it was raised at one of the meetings, and I don't know what page it's on, but I thought there was something in the open space plan that actually identified this.
Actually, in the West Boylston production plan, it states housing that would be most appropriate with respect to the town's land use goals and environmental consideration is small scale development that fits in the context of existing neighborhoods. That's right out of
the housing production plan, yeah. Right.
Right.
And how about, and the master plan, I think, predates that and says that the same essential points.
Yeah, I think the master plan, the open space component, identified this parcel as a potential candidate to be acquired by the town to maintain it for open space purposes.
Correct. Yeah.
There, that's important in the minutes. All right. How about aligns with the house production goals? Bob alluded to that it does not.
It does not.
Oh, wait, let's go. All right, aligns with goals in the master plan. Is that a yes or a no?
It's a no for me.
No.
No. Anna Mary? Anna Mary said no. Mark?
I have this as a 50%, so I'm going to have to go with a no.
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 All right. No, for me as well. Aligns with the housing production goals. Bob articulated one of the points. Chris Berglund?
Yeah, I don't think it does for that purpose. Yeah, the purpose that Bob mentioned.
Yeah. Anna Mary?
No.
Mark?
I had a 40%, so I'm going to say no.
No, okay, good. And Bob?
I'm a no.
I'm a no, and I'm a no. And how about the housing needs analysis? That's not as clear. No, I mean it. The housing needs analysis identified a severe need for senior housing, and that has not been articulated in this plan. But I'm not prepared to say a yes or no on this.
I don't think any of them really, address that, to be honest. So, I mean, in my mind, at least, I think they're all kind of.
I asked that question of one couple, and they said, well, it's a first floor. They claim the first floor will adopt that, will answer that.
Yeah.
So what are you thinking? About aligning with the housing needs analysis. Anna Mary?
I have written down from when they did their presentation that they were going to have elevators in the buildings. And if there were elevators in the buildings, then that one I would say might be a yes.
See, I forgot. In the 235 program?
No. I mean, 18 Walden Street.
Ali's going to have elevators?
No,
not Ali.
The other one. Benicasa's.
Benicasa, I'm sorry. No, that's right. They're going to have elevators. You're right.
So I would say yes to that one section.
I think, you know, thank you for correcting us. She's right.
She is, but he did say that he was actually going for the younger population, the teachers and the you know, millennials.
But well, with a building that has an elevator in it does accommodate people who are elderly or handicapped.
You're right, it does.
You're right. Okay, I'm not going to amend my vote. I have to say yes.
I'm going to stick with them.
You're going to stick with them? Okay, how about you, Bob?
I'm going to say yes, but reluctantly.
Yeah.
Marshall's so still in.
Which one are we?
Oh, we're I'm sorry. The house.
Housing needs analysis.
Yeah.
I would say no. I mean, I would think, and Anna Marie, in you know, respect, I would think that the elevator option might come in more on the next one, which is a variety of housing options. But maybe I'm.
I thought that's the one we were on.
Okay.
I'm sorry, that's the one I'm reacting to.
Okay.
But you pointed out though that the elevator building in 118 Walden Street could address the needs of seniors.
Yes, right. Absolutely.
As long as it's elevated. So I had to amend the housing needs analysis vote that I made because it would.
So I would agree with that then, yes, because it does provide need access to all.
Okay, then down to number four, a variety of housing options, affordability and population served. Yes, I guess, yes.
Yes, indeed.
Yes. How, Anna Mary?
Yes.
Yes, Mark?
Okay, I'll say yes because there's so many. Yes.
Yes, okay, so.
Yeah, Madam Chair, I think I will say that again, just that the affordability option is really not any, none of these really check that box. This is giving the access option that I think the other two have not.
Exactly. And the preferential option, we all know about that. Okay, now we're down to location and siting criteria. Proximity to public transportation. Marsha's a no.
No, for me.
Chris is a no.
I'm a 0%.
Who is that? Really? No. No. No.
Anna Mary's a no.
And Pat Halpin, no. All right. How about proximity to retail groceries and stores?
No.
No.
0%.
No.
No.
No. Okay. Existing traffic and pedestrian ways adequately serve the project?
No.
No.
Mark.
Zero. No. It's nice that the park is near there, but not on the traffic side. Okay.
No. That's uniform. All right. Existing public utility, sewer, water adequately serve the site?
Not at this time that I'm aware of.
No.
No.
Mark.
We have to say no right now.
Pardon me?
We have to say no right now. Or I have to say
no. No. And no. Generally conforms to existing neighborhood development. Chris?
I don't think so. No. No. Does not appear to.
No.
No.
What story buildings thought?
Also 0%.
No.
And Anna Mary?
No.
Okay. Located at underutilized commercial site. No.
It's not. Not even what it is.
No. Create small-scale neighborhood development.
No.
He claims to try. I mean, he that's the only thing he gets like a 10% off, because that's what he's saying that he would.
Well, he's going to have that little.
Yeah.
The dog park.
Yeah, dog park and the ring that he could want. I mean, that's the only thing he gets even the 10%. But still no.
Minimum 25% affordable rental units. Yes.
Yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He's going to be legal. So.
Provide affordable units for less than 50%.
No.
No. did not.
Provide affordable units with universal access. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not too much. Yeah.
Anna Mary?
Yes.
All right. Looking over your assessment, gentlemen and ladies, are you prepared to vote on this motion?
Yes.
Okay. It will do a roll call vote. Chris Berglund?
I would vote no to recommending this.
Bob Barrow?
No.
Marcia Clarence?
No.
Mark Frieden?
As the, with my Affordable Housing Trust hat on, I'm going to say even no on this one.
Anna Mary?
No.
Pat Halpin, a no. So clearly this will not be forwarded to the Board of Select Board, rather, to pursue a LIP. And with that, our business tonight is done. Unless you have something more to talk about. It was clear. It's very clear.
Madam Chair, before you adjourn, I suggest that you take a vote to formally reduce your recommendations in writing to the Select Board and other
committees. Would you say?
Before you adjourn, I recommend that you make a motion to formally submit your recommendations in writing to the Select Board.
That Jennifer Diamond, Warren Diamond will formally
reduce.
How's that?
Just say so moved.
All right. So moved. Did you understand it? What I just all
right. I'm writing them. Got it.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 And all.
Aye.
Second.
Roll call.
Roll call. Anna Mary?
Yeah, she doesn't talk now that we're
say yes and thank Jennifer.
Thank you, Jennifer. Yes.
Mark?
Yes.
Yes.
Chris?
Chris Berglund, yes.
Yeah.
Marcia, Pat, and with our gratitude. And
thank you.
All right. And I want to, we will do that ASAP. And we need to set a date for our next meeting. How is Tuesday, January 31st?
It works, January.
Works for me.
That's okay. They can do that.
It works for Chris.
Yeah, Berglund. I know. Yeah, I have it in already.
Works for Mark.
It's good.
Mark, do you want to do it through Zoom?
What are we talking
about? You don't have to.
Just doing minutes?
Know, unless you all want to keep coming.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know what's on the agenda.
Do you have anything critical on that agenda?
It's Lynn Rogers, going forth with the LDS.
Oh, yeah, we can do that.
Whatever. And also the
some of the training aids, maybe
Bill Scanlon's.
But it's not a big interactive public thing.
So no, it would. So I think Zoom would work.
Zoom is, okay. I'm good for Zoom.
Would you like to do Zoom on?
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. We will do that.
At six.
And thank you all for coming, but remember, one of the things we need to keep in mind that just Elisa.
Oh, Elisa Wellington from Malden Street. I just wanted to thank the Affordable Housing Trust for all the work they've done in these proposals, and for all the work they've done prior to these proposals. Because I was just talking to a friend from Princeton. And they don't even have a housing production plan yet, which makes them very vulnerable to Chapter 40B projects. And I was so proud that I could tell her that our Affordable Housing Trust already had that, and, you know, gave guidelines and everything. And so I just want to thank all of you for keeping us up to date. We're way ahead of many other towns in the state, which makes us less vulnerable. And having served on the planning board for 14 years, I know how much work it is to come up with these plans and keep up with everything we have to do. So thank you for being so up to date.
If only people would read the plans. or developers read the plans. It would be very helpful. Secondly, I recommend to all of you, please get involved. We said this at the last meeting, not just when an issue comes in my yard, I hate that expression, but you know, not when it affects me personally, but when it affects the town. We all have to think of the common good. What is the common good? And if something is happening across the town and bothering a neighborhood, we need to be present for it and apply all the rules justly and with vigor. And as I laughingly said the last time, but it's not funny, you know, we are aging out of this. And we need people with natural colored hair to come forward, to come forward and be present and become involved. And I think, you know, it's important. And so as issues, stay attuned to issues. Help Jennifer Warren Diamond. She's great and she's so helpful. And when an issue comes forward, everyone come out for your neighbor across town, not just your neighbor next door. Is that fair? So thank you for coming and being so polite. And we won't be seeing you anymore, we hope, except in the grocery store. So thanks so much. Stay well. A motion to adjourn.
Second. Somebody else will take a second.
All right. All in favor?
Aye. Anna Mary says aye.
Mark says aye.
Bob says aye.
I say aye.
Anna Mary, have fun in Florida.
Chris Berglund,
thank
aye.
Thank you.